This guidance is one of the most important pieces of a state aid modernization strategy launched in May 2012, 2 years ago, and in my view constitutes an excellent example of what we can consider as good state aid. It means state aid contributes to a sustainable growth path by providing what the market fails to deliver on its own to improve competitiveness and productivity. The member states will have much more flexibility for implementing their measures in this area. New categories of aid will benefit from an exemption from prior notification to the Commission. For instance, the aid for the construction of research infrastructure or for the upgrading of these infrastructures, aid the measures to support innovation clusters, or aid to organize innovation, clearly receive a more flexible treatment with the combined effect of the guidelines and the block exemption regulation. Of course, this will ask us stronger efforts to monitor ex post what is going on with all these measures that have not been notified ex ante. This is our challenge, and I am convinced that in the next years we will be able to reinforce our monitoring tasks to combine the use, the adequate use of a state aid to protect the good functioning of our internal market with the simplification and with the trust on the way member states will make use of this new framework. We are increasing the obligations to publish in a transparent way aid given by member states when this aid is above 500,000 euros. These transparency requirements, that I know that are not accepted immediately by some people, but are a necessary complement of the way we try to simplify the management of a state aid and at the same time to guarantee that the state aid is going in the good direction, is supporting good objectives and priorities and not distorting the functioning of our internal market.